Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. This video is about necessity, the defense of necessity. So you are still on unlawful conduct. This is the last video on unlawful conduct for now. So necessity is like a twin for private defense. Usually you would use necessity when you can't use private defense. So private defense is only for a situation where you are protecting yourself or someone from an unlawful attack. So that means the attack must be from a person. So you can't use private defense in situations where the threat or danger is not from an unlawful act, an unlawful conduct, or an unlawful attack. And you can't use private defense when the threat is from something else. So I'll make a few examples so that you can understand where you would use necessity. So let's say in a situation where you are attacked by an animal, because an animal, you can't use private defense against an animal because the animal cannot do an unlawful act or cannot unlawfully attack you. So the court does not regard animals as being capable of making crimes. So the courts, there are no crimes that can be made by animals. So in a situation where maybe you are attacked by a dog, maybe you can use your weapon, and if you are arrested for some reason, then you can use the defense of necessity, meaning that it was necessary, there was no other way. So you, in a situation like that, you would not use private defense. Another situation will be from an act of God. Maybe there was fire created by lightning. So in a situation like this, maybe you would break down the door to save yourself, or break down the door to save someone's life. In a situation where maybe you are charged against malicious injury to property, then you can use the defense of necessity by saying it was necessary. So that's another situation where you can use the defense of necessity. Another situation would be, let's say you are a parent and your son just swallowed a lot of pills. You realize that your son just swallowed a lot of pills, so you decide to take him to the hospital. And on your way to the hospital, you are obviously speeding and you are going over the speed limits. So when, or if you are arrested for not following the rules of the road, driving above the required speed limit, so in a situation like that, you can use the defense of necessity, meaning that it was necessary for me to drive at that speed because I was trying to save someone's life. You can save your own life or someone else's life. So if you have seen our video about private defense, you would know that there are requirements. The requirements are really the same. The requirements for the threats and the requirements for the response. So just from those examples, you can understand that obviously there will be requirements for the threat or danger. So and one requirement will be that it must be a legally protected interest. So we have talked about that in private defense. So meaning it must be maybe your life or your bodily integrity or those things, those legally protected interests, but it can't be economic. It can't be a mere economic interest. So, in a situation where the interest is purely economic, you cannot use the defense of necessity. So that's how things would go. So if you are saving someone's life, or if you are saving someone from some kind of harm, then you can use the defense of necessity. So it must be a legally protected interest. So one of the requirements for the response is that the response must not be unreasonable, or it must not create so much harm that what I mean to say here is that there must be a balance. So maybe I break the law, and that's breaking the law. Maybe I break the door. I break the door to get inside to save your life. So in a situation like that, the courts will look at the harm created, which was the damage to the property, the damage to the door, and they would weigh that against saving someone's life. So in other words, you must choose between two evils. You can't use necessity in a situation where there is no evil, which means, in other words, you can't just use necessity as a defense where you don't have to choose between two evils. So the evil you choose must be the lesser evil. So it must be reasonable. The response must be reasonable. I can't create more harm than the harm I'm trying to avoid. So that is the requirement. So I cannot create more harm than the harm I'm trying to avoid. Another requirement is that the harm I'm trying to avoid must not be from my own conduct or from my own negligence or something like this. Maybe if I set fire in the house. So if I set fire in the house and now I'm trying to save myself, in a situation like that, the setting of fire is an unlawful act. I cannot be expected to benefit from it. So there is a fundamental rule in our law that you cannot benefit from your own conduct, from your own unlawful conduct. So I can't just set fire on someone's house and break down the door to get out. So in a situation like that, the court is most likely not going to accept my defense of necessity. But there are some academics that argue that the prior conduct must be separated from the second conduct, so from the consequence. So in a situation like that, maybe you would be charged, or you would be held liable for the first act, if that act was unlawful. So that is another requirement. Another requirement would be that so another requirement is that the danger must be imminent or must have already commenced. So I cannot use necessity where the danger is not something imminent, or it has not started. I cannot use the defense of necessity for some harm that will occur in the future. So, going back to that requirement of that the act must be necessary, it does not mean that there must be no other alternative. So it must not mean that there must be no better way to do it, but it must be necessary in a situation where maybe I'm trying to save someone's life or my life. So the defense of necessity is quite broad. Compulsion is also a defense under necessity, which means you arguing that it was necessary because there was a gun on my head. I had to crack that safe, because if I did not crack the safe, the person who was compelling me to crack the safe would have killed me. So you can use that defense. And there is a case where a ship wrecked and they went 17 days without food. Half of those days without food, and the second half of those days without food and water. So they decided that they would kill a 17 years old boy, because the boy would be the first to die because he was weak. They decided to kill him. They kill him and they ate him. 5 days later, they got rescued, and they were charged. They were accused of murder, and the courts held that they were criminally liable. So the basic reasoning behind that is that you can't use necessity to save your own life and sacrifice another person's life. So the defense of necessity cannot be used by to say that it was necessary, I had to kill him to save my own life. So in a situation like that, the courts is most likely not going to accept the your defense of necessity. There was another case where the accused was forced by the first accused. The second accused was forced by the first accused to tie the deceased. So the second accused tied the deceased, and the first accused had a knife. So he told the second accused that if you do not do everything I say, I will kill you. So the second accused got some rope and tied the deceased. After tying him, the first accused stabbed the deceased, killing him. So the first accused and the second accused were accused for killing the deceased. So the second accused escaped liability, escaped criminal liability, just because he was not. Yes, the him tying the deceased was unlawful, but he was compelled to do so, and he escaped liability on that situation just because he is not the one who performed the killing. So that's why he escaped liability. Maybe it would have been a different case if they gave him the knife and they told him to stab the deceased. So in a situation like that, so the court does not expect people to be heroes, but they do not expect you to kill someone out of necessity to kill an innocent person. So as I should have said, the defense of necessity is used when you have caused harm to an innocent party, or in a situation where there was no violence at all. So the defense of necessity arises in situations where you cause harm to an innocent third party, or you did not cause harm to a person, but you caused harm maybe to property. The defense of necessity arises in those situations where the threat is not just from another person, but it could be from an animal, or things like lightning, or just necessity. So that is the most important part about necessity. So you can use necessity in situations where you are compelled to do something, and then you can say it was necessary. But you can just use necessity when it comes to omissions. To defend against omissions, you'll have to use the defense of impossibility. So the defense of necessity is only relevant when it comes to a positive act. So in a situation where you think it was necessary, but you find out that it was not really necessary. So in a situation where you rely on putative necessity, which means you believe that it was necessary, maybe you thought you were breaking the door to save someone's life, but you then realize that you just have damaged the property for nothing. There was no one inside. So in a situation like that, you cannot use the defense of necessity, but you can use that defense to escape liability, maybe by using that defense on a different element, like criminal capacity or faults. So maybe you would prove that you did not have the necessary intention to commit the act, and you would escape liability, but your conduct would have been held to be unlawful. So, in a situation where you cannot argue that it was necessary to do something, if at the time of doing that thing you did not know it was necessary to do something, so you cannot break the door and find out, well, just that by breaking the door you have helped save someone's life. But at the time when you decided to break the door, you were just trying to cause damage, and you later realized that actually you saved someone's life. So in a situation like that, you cannot use the defense of necessity. So it must be on your mind that what you are doing is necessary. So I'll end it there when it comes to necessity. I'll make the next videos will be about other elements like criminal capacity and faults. We'll come back maybe some months later and talk about other defenses, like other defenses that exclude unlawful conduct. So I'll end the video there for now. Thank you.